3 years ago, I quit my job to become a self-employed filmmaker, a dream that I'd had since childhood. No leads, no guarantees, and if a pitch is worth 1,000 words, I guess that means a video is worth considerably more. One of the two absolute highlights of my little filmmaking career was shooting a commercial for Spotify and Mini Cooper. I cannot wait for you to see it. I also cannot wait for Spotify and Mini Cooper to see it. Let's do this. Okay, I thought I'd put the grand stage aside for an episode and film in here. Does it tie into the story, or is my student budget showing? So a year into full-time filmmaking, I was out and about in Alberta, Canada, or out in a boat in Alberta, Canada. I'm hopping in my obnoxiously British Mini Cooper, shooting a friend's music video one weekend.
This is how you do it.
Somebody pays them per hour. They're paying way too much.
Stop getting that on camera!
And whatever this is the next weekend, sure, my rent is due. And look, I was grateful for any piece of work that I could get my hands on, but deep down, I want to make a commercial for Mini Cooper. For me, that commercial was the bucket list item. But there were two strange hurdles I kept running into. The first problem, get this, Mini Cooper isn't reaching out to me. Kind of at all.
I'm waiting!
Well, you know, I had this dream, but I wasn't forcefully given the opportunity.
I've done everything I can. He didn't give it to me.
But that's not even on me. The second was this weird response, one that I fundamentally disagree with. Have you ever explained a dream of yours and heard this? Well, if it's meant to be, it'll just happen.
Huh? Wait, what?
What?
Huh?
But flipping no, mate! Flipping no! Absolutely not! Is there any better way of just washing your hands of all accountability? Well, if it's meant to be, it'll just happen. Look them dead in the eye and say, flipping no, mate! Even with the accent, do it with the accent. Even if you're from, you know, like, Wisconsin. So thanks to game-changing advice from an editor in New York who we will meet shortly, I believe the greatest opportunities that we will ever come across, I believe they will come from being proactive, not from being patient. So, we had our mission. A group of filmmaking friends and I, we decided that rather than waiting on this hypothetical phone call from companies that had never heard our names, we were gonna make ads for companies that never asked for them.
Let's make it happen.
First up was Spotify, making it very clear that these companies did not ask us to make these videos. This is free advertising.
It's a gray area, give me that.
It's happy to get the word out and support a local business. The premise for the commercial is this. For the worker, the commuter, the couple, the student, thanks to Spotify and that perfect song, they can do Monday mornings differently.
Okay, so that's your marker.
And no pressure.
These are the scenes, and we're going behind them. Roland! Okay, you and I, right here, right now, we are living in the golden age of opportunity and accessibility.
What happened is that these gatekeepers all at once lost their power. If you want to make a record, make a record. If you want to write, write.
Just make really incredible, you know, incredible projects without having to wait for someone else to tell you yes.
That idea of picking yourself is available now because communication is so easy.
Alarm's gone off, just kind of rummage around a little bit.
Sorry for the lack of excuses, but geography means less and less. Technology is more readily available.
My HBO show was shot on a point and shoot that we bought at Walmart.
Slide in.
Yeah, slide in, ready? Round of to the left, to the right, we'll do more shimmying. And while in the pursuit of passions, yeah, there are some decisions that need to be made by other people. Books need publishers, products need distribution, YouTubers need subscribers just to feel something. But in the meantime, what are you doing? Also, so much more fun than waiting.
Oh, hi.
Hello! You're lucky we weren't shimmying. We would have hit you.
Hey, Joe, you are the author, writer of your own story. So please don't ever give the pen to somebody else.
If there's still work to be done, if there's still more people to call, then that is procrastination disguised as patience. If I'm spending more time talking about giving a TED talk than, you know, actually writing one, that's not patience. That is wishful thinking. Repeatedly telling people you want to build a business without an actual mapped out business model, that's boasting about something fictitious. Telling people I'm sure that I could be a movie star if I could get out of this place. Billy Joel, please tell that guy, that's not patient. That's entitlement built on excuses. He needs to get out of that bar and shoot a short film with his friends, like today. There is, of course, a time to be patient. In fact, if you're real good at it, there is literally all the time in the world.
Oh, I don't need this.
Somebody will come.
But patience should be reserved only for when you have done all you possibly can.
Somebody! Hello!
Okay. I think the point's across. Let's watch the commercial. I am so excited to share this with you.
Monday morning. Let's do it differently.
Get up. Get up now.
Open Spotify.
Spotify. We do Monday mornings differently.
And it was so much fun. I watched the bloopers and behind the scenes for these videos weekly. It was such a fun shoot. This whole experience, this potential PR nightmare for someone out there, it all came about because of a 15-minute phone call I had with an editor in New York City. The one, the only, Chrissy Rabe. She's done work with Nike, Calvin Klein, Louis Vuitton. A real who's who and who can make my portfolio feel a little bit inferior. All of this is because of her advice to choose to be proactive instead of choosing to be patient. And who, years later, I got to reconnect with and once again, thank her for changing the game.
You want to do car commercials, go film cars, go rent a car. Those companies are going to look at it and go, we need to have this person on board. Oh, they know what they're doing.
If you actually go forward and mean it, I found that the world will actually acquiesce and go, yep, I'll give you a green on that.
You really have to be proactive.
Hey, Joe, if you don't ask, you don't get.
It takes courage to speak up, to ask for what you want, to own your worth.
Don't wait for the phone to ring. Generate the work yourself.
If you don't have that work to show people, go create it.
You'll get recognized for doing that work. You will get hired for doing that work.
You need that with $1,000. If we give you $20,000, what can you make then?
You only get like a nugget of time to really pursue the things you care about.
Your future is whatever you make it. I'll make it a good one.
Make proactivity the byproduct of passion. Otherwise, we're idle. We're powerless. We've decided that productivity can only be given fuel by permission. Fucking no. And by the way, if the only return we got on this project was experience, practice, and really great memories, well, that would be good enough for any of us. That being said, excuse me.
Oh man, okay.
Last week, I got an email from a marketing executive at Mini Cooper. They recently let me borrow a 2022 Mini Cooper Countryman. I don't even think this guy's even on the market yet. They asked if I would make them something similar to what we made with the obnoxiously British Mini Cooper. Don't be patient. Be proactive. I missed the stage. One, it's not a billion degrees. When I'm on stage, I'm delivering a message. Passion is forthright. It's expected. It's good. Right now, I could just be the psycho in a Walmart parking lot just having a bit of a breakdown or an episode.